Well, nothing like the present to get started, right? Are you in a comfortable seated position where the physical body can relax? One of the things we're going to meditate on today is our vibration. So recently I was listening to a YouTube video, and this gentleman talks about the shift happens on an energetic level, not necessarily a mental level. So we may be consumed with the idea of trying to change our mind. But it's also important to realize that we need to change our vibration. If we want to have prosperity, then we'll need to raise our vibration. If we want to have more love in our lives, we'll need to raise our vibration. If we want to experience whatever that is, the possibility is that your vibration needs to shift in order for that to come into fruition. So as you close your eyes and draw your attention inward, practicing that sense of self, the idea is to be a witness versus the judge. The witness is just an observer. It has no opinion. What is your vibration currently like? Does it feel good? Is it familiar? Is your body here, but your mind is somewhere else? We can gently say to ourselves, I'd like to be present. No ridicule required. We're going to help make that happen by creating a brand new grounding cord in present time. It goes from the base of the spine all the way down to the center of the planet. This is going to help us get rooted. And notice how just the subtleties of becoming grounded to the center of the planet begins to shift your energy. Isn't that a beautiful thing? At the same time, let's begin to call earth energy in that feminine aspect to life. Let's just describe it today as soft. It'll come up through the leg channels, goes right into the first chakra, and it goes down to the center of the planet. allow yourself to sort of relax into that softness. Releasing tension within the physical body. Maybe you lean back a little bit more and breathe a little bit deeper. Letting go of the doing. And taking our meditation practice a step further, we'll invite Father Sky to come in through the top of the head. And allow it to go down the two back channels all the way to the base of the spine. And this element is very airy. So let's use that to really open up and expand our auric field. So the soft can get even bigger and softer. Helping us let go of the doing. Earth and cosmic energy is going to run up the front channels. And that excess energy is going to come out the top of the head. It's going to go back up into the stars. I'm going to give it to our higher self. All these life experiences are meant for our own evolution. So instead of holding on to them and making them some scars or vasanas, let's give them back to our spirit who created the experience. And allowing it to feed our spirit, our evolution, and shift our vibration. I think it's important to discern that the things you want to let go of were never yours to begin with. Consider them like other people's problems. Easy to get that confused. And the things we want to give to our higher self, our spirit, are our life lessons. So as we process, there's energy that will go down the grounding cord that we've mistaken as ourself or as ours. And there are things that will go back to the sky that are ours. Can we begin to discern the difference? Where may we be taking on someone else's karma? There is an energy between the third chakra, which is right above the belly button, and the heart chakra, which is at the chest. And I'd like you to put your attention on that connection between the third chakra and the fourth. and begin to unwind whatever resides within there. The difference between the third chakra is it is an internal chakra that is influenced by how we see the world. It is impacted by our external world. The news, TV, interactions, work. School, politics. It can be very conflicted. It is also has a direct correlation to our sense of self, making things even more confusing. And the heart chakra is an internal chakra. Coming in and going out, it is internal, internal, internal. Notice how it wants to be freed from the external world. It would like to be freed from our beliefs, our rules, our regulations, our expectations. It would like to be freed from the third chakra. Notice that the heart is ready and able to move forward. And then it desperately wants to shine. The stronger the connection with our hearts, the less we will have to hide. Learning to love our little idiosyncrasies, and the big ones too. And as our heart begins to shine, allow it to turn bright green. Coming back into balance with Mother Nature. Nature does not see itself separate, but as one. Water does not see itself as bottled water, glass of water, jar of water, lake, river, ocean, pond, puddle. Let's follow the laws of nature. All is one. And bring your attention to how your vibration has shifted. Make a mental note of this. How fruitful it is to make the time to sit in quiet manifesting our own transformations. Acknowledging our connection with the divine. And we'll stretch up towards the sky and come out of trance.